So for those of you who follow me along on Instagram, I think you guys know that I am currently in Mexico. But typically speaking, when you're like on vacation, you're not really supposed to be working or doing. This isn't work to me. I definitely have to show you guys what I experienced. You see, the other day I was on the beach and just walking along, minding my own business. What the heck are these guys, by the way? And I come across a stingray. Of course, I lost my mind, had to film it. I only have my GoPro with me, so I don't know the footage that I'm getting and what I'm not getting. But seeing this guy in the wild was absolutely amazing. It's actually just a round stingray, one of the smallest saltwater stingrays in the world, only getting to about 12 inches across. The one that I found was a female in like ankle deep water, absolutely mesmerizing. And while I seen this guy, I decided, you know what? I'm gonna take the camera and see what else I can find. And we found some damsels and some sergeant majors and a bunch of other tiny little fish. And then later on, we found more stingrays, which was absolutely phenomenal. I couldn't believe it. You guys know that I love freshwater stingrays. And seeing a saltwater stingray in the wild is absolutely phenomenal as well. One thing you guys don't know about me though is I can't stand getting in the ocean. Why? Because I don't know what's in it. I don't know if it's gonna crawl on me. I don't want it touching me. Seaweed, et cetera, et cetera. But it dawned on me, I'm a fish keeper. I know exactly what's in the ocean. So for the first time ever, I've been getting in the ocean and just exploring it. It's just been absolutely incredible experience. But lately what I'm doing is, and what I'm going to be doing today with you guys is, you guys know I'm setting up that 375-gallon saltwater aquarium. Brought the squad as well, of course. And I'm gonna check around just to get a little bit of inspiration. So the cool fish are gonna be over here, most likely in the darker parts, around the rocky crevices. I'm also gonna go over here. That's a Mayan ruin, by the way. I was already over there and explored a lot of things. The stingray was right along the beach here, just swimming along. And then the other ray was right over here. Anyways, we're gonna get in the water and we're gonna see what we can find, because I know there's a ton of fish here. Yeah, so I think I'm gonna start right around this area. Again, just going to see what's here, what's not. And of course, this is a trafficked area where people are swimming and exploring on their own. So it's not gonna have a ton of coral or anything like that, but I'm not gonna be doing a coral tank. I'm going to be doing something like this with simple rocks and algae, some outcrops, and a ton of fun and colorful fish. But what I wanna see is how the fish are behaving out here, what they're actually doing, where they're spending their most time. And then of course, that's gonna give us more ideas for when we set up our own aquarium. But right now, one of the things we're gonna notice here, they're gonna take you under for a quick second. Is sand, crushed coral. We also have lots of rocks. It's just very simplistic, very inspiring. The moment I got in here earlier today, I was like, oh, I know what I want to do for my own saltwater tank. I'm gonna see how far we can get out here. The water's a little bit cold, but once you get in, and you just gotta get in, you'll be fine. Let's go. Yes, right off the bat, a little bit of algae. We got some outcrops, sand, and this is ancient. This isn't man-made. This has been here for thousands and thousands of years. So we're getting a really good idea of what we could potentially do in our own aquariums. And I think one of the things that we do, what I've seen with saltwater aquariums, is so many people make them so pretty and pristine, where I'm more like, it's all about the fish and how are they going to interact with their environment. What better way than to jump into the ocean and see everything. I know this isn't the Great Barrier Reef or some exotic reef, but baby steps for us, right? Wow, so much of the fish are camouflaged to this specific area. And I think that that is interesting to see, because a lot of the most colorful saltwater fish spend their time around coral, which is also extremely colorful. I wonder if that has anything to do with their evolution. See this? It's literally the same size as my brain. Where you going? Come back out here. Stop being so crabby. Also, the water's about 25 degrees Celsius. Just had it checked. Which is interesting. A lot of times in fresh water, we crank our tanks way up to like 28, which is definitely not necessary. I'm going into some crazy spots here. what that is, but his camouflage, something else, isn't it? Love it. I don't need to see the most colorful fish. I just love to enjoy what's here. Just, even if it means if they're not that colorful, I get to see them in their natural habitat and swim with them if just for a moment. I see some big things moving around down there. See everything blowing around in there? Yeah, me too. I'm blowing around with it. Some bigger fish bit my leg.
That better taste good.
I don't know where I've blown off into, but fish here are incredible. Look at this little guy. Trapped in this little pool of water. You guys see him? All by himself. Probably has to wait for high tide. There he goes. This water's super, super warm. I feel like I should get him out of there, rescue him somehow. Where'd he go? You see him? I don't know where he went. Look at the goby! I think that's a goby. One of the things that I get asked a lot is like, hey, I live near a beach or I could do this, or a river, can I take rocks or sand from it, and I'm just gonna go ahead and say that it's probably illegal to do so without a permit. I once got a permit, it was a hassle, it took me weeks to get it, but and you're only allowed so much. But the fish are everywhere. Look at these guys. Yeah, so you might just want to double think taking anything from nature that's not yours, not on your property, and certainly without permission, is probably just not a good idea to do it. Ooh, there's some big fellas back here. There's so many fish for such like a publicly available beach. For so many different varieties of fish to still be surviving. I think a lot of it's protected by like all these sharp rocks and stuff. Nobody really wants to go near them. But as a fish keeper, I certainly want to take a peek, disturb as least amount as possible. Maybe I'm stirring up a little bit of sand, but yeah. However, on something like this that's supposed to be a vacation, I probably shouldn't be filming at all. Probably shouldn't be doing any of this. I don't know how I'm gonna edit this or get it out to you guys, but I hope you certainly enjoyed it. If you did enjoy it, make sure you leave a thumbs up. Subscribe if you're not already. Who knows what's coming next? We do know a 375-gallon saltwater tank's coming. 2000's getting redone, and every other aquarium in the gallery, which I can't wait to get back to.
Who just said you? Is it you?
No, there
it
is.
Did you say you?
What's that imprint, Michelle?
Oh yeah, there's whatchamacallit? Fossils everywhere. Yeah, you can see fossils everywhere.
I don't know what type those are. But I bet you, oh, here's another imprint of a fossil.
Yeah, they're everywhere. Well, these are ancient, ancient areas. Been around for a very long time. And if you look closely, you'll find actual fossils. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I will see you in the next one. Hey, you did it again.
That was me.
It was you. Yeah, I wasn't planning on filming any of this or doing any of this, to be honest with you. But as soon as I seen that stingray, I knew. I just got too excited. I was like, I have to show the people that actually care. Nobody else cared, only you guys.